global demand for solar and renewables has never been higher. It truly, on a dollars per megawatt hour basis, is competitive with any other source of energy out there. Our relationship with FLIR began with our customers. You know, they were already using, you know, a lot of FLIR technology in the field, but then when that intersected with the rise of drone technology, all of a sudden you had this magical moment where you had thermal imaging cameras in the air covering solar farms and generating digital data.
The process that we used to use was having some guy sit in a room looking at dozens and dozens of photos from a FLIR camera, trying to create a map of where these problems were so that we could go out and fix them. Since we started using Raptor Maps, their technology does all this for us. We're able to fly a site, give them the raw sensor data, they're able to run it through their system, and within a few days, produce a map and a report identifying where all the problems are, as well as the cost related to those problems.
There are a lot of components that are a part of this, right? So you've got motors that actually control big sections of how they tilt. Those motors can fail. Inherently, the modules start to not perform as well as they should. Maybe the glass got shattered, and you can see that really well in thermal. We can also see what we call warrantable issues. With these modules, they have long lifetimes, and if they're not performing, you have to have that evidence to be able to take that back to the manufacturer and say, hey, I need a new batch so I can get this solar farm up and running at peak efficiency.
We do this so that we don't have any surprises on site. We do this so that we can hand over the site to the owner, knowing that there's no issues, knowing that they're going to have the maximum energy production, they have the best quality product that was delivered to them in the safest fashion.
No one company and no one person makes the solar industry work. It really is a partnership. If you don't have the best software tools, the most efficient practices, you're going to slow the growth of renewables in a time when it is absolutely critical that the world makes this transition.